There's pretty much like a space race in terms of Nintendo YouTubers right now. I like to call it the space race of the coinless speedruns. Okay? All right? If you look at YouTube and you go on YouTube and you type coinless Mario, okay? Let's see. Let's see. Coinless Mario. All right? Look at this. There's like a gazillion videos about beating different games with no coins, and they all have so many views. So I was thinking, I was like, wait a minute, dude. Has anybody done coinless Mario Odyssey? All the people that have done it haven't done it in like interesting ways or like in like a legitimate video. I'll just do it and showcase what it's like trying to beat Mario Odyssey without coins. Also, I've never done it before, and I'll showcase the failures, the hardships, the successes, all in one video. And maybe it'll go viral and get like 1 million views. Have you guys heard about this YouTuber recently that got like banned and like censored and like isn't allowed to make any videos? Mumkey Jones, have you guys heard about it? All of Mumkey's channels, even his new ones that he tried to make, gone. They're dead. It's over, dude. He's not allowed on YouTube. YouTube does not want him on their platform, which makes sense because like he made a bunch of content about school shooters and stuff. I was thinking about making a school shooter video. But now I'm really worried. I don't want to make one because I'm scared that YouTube's gonna like censor me and take away my channel. Here's some school shooter. No, I'm not saying I want to be a school shooter. That's not what I'm saying. I'm saying, okay. I'm not saying I want to be a school shooter. I don't want to ship any schools. What I'm saying is like, I think everybody has thought, okay, what would it be like if I was a school shooter? And what would it be like if there was a school, if there was like a school shooting happening and I was like one of the students? Because I thought about that a lot. I don't want to collect any coins, guys. Oh my God. Okay, we almost collected a coin there, but it didn't happen.
One, two, three.
There we go. Okay, we didn't collect any coins. Yeah, we can't do Dino Skip. I kind of realized that as it was happening. So we're just gonna do this jump. So right here, guys, first thing that we should probably note for a coinless run is we're doing this jump instead of Dino Skip because Dino Skip over here, it caused you to collect a coin. Like, I think you have to break that fossil over there, which has coins in it automatically. But we can just do that jump to completely skip it. So there you go. And then there's a bunch of coins over there, but we can easily just avoid those. We made it through Cascade Kingdom pretty easily. Wasn't much of a challenge. There you go. We said to be a little bit careful of coins. We didn't do Dino Skip. We did a different way to get up. Here we go. Sand Kingdom. Gotta be careful. I actually have no idea what's going on with the Sand Kingdom or how this is gonna work out, how this is gonna play. I've had people tell me that like ghosts are definitely real. By the way, we almost collected a coin there. We freaking spawned the coin, but we didn't collect it. We gotta be careful. I'm ripping off Sieve. Yeah, dude, I don't give a shit. What? My entire YouTube career, I've been ripping off people. Are you kidding me? See, that's the thing, dude. People like call out other YouTubers for ripping other YouTubers off. Like, I remember like Mero got called out on Twitter, and Mero had to like go through like all these lengths to like defend himself and explain why he's not ripping off other YouTubers. Dude, you tell me I'm ripping off a YouTuber, you're probably right. I probably am ripping off another YouTuber. I rip off a lot of people. That's kind of like the only reason my channel's anything. If I didn't rip people off, dude, I don't know where I'd be. Whenever I hang out with my friends, I feel guilty about it because I'm like, man, I should be making a video right now. I have this horrible mentality that YouTube has instilled in me, where I feel bad for doing things that is social, for socializing with other humans. I feel bad about it. It's horrible, dude. And I can't not think about YouTube. My other friends, like, they have jobs, so. Oh, dude, I just realized we have to be careful of coins here. Okay, we're good though. Like, my other friends, like, they have regular jobs, so it's like, okay, you go to your job and you think about work, and then when you're not at your job, you don't think about work. But then with YouTube, you're always thinking about it. By the way, aren't there coins down here? I don't know. I thought there were. I gotta be really careful. But what if my friends are girls? Oh, no, they're not. Don't worry. Dude's like trying to defend me. Guys, what if his friends are girls? No, they're not. I got coins. God damn it. I saw that coming before it even happened. Okay. We just collected coins. So what I'll do is, like I said, we want to see if it's possible to beat the game without collecting any coins. So we'll just load this save file. We're gonna try to make it through the game without collecting any coins, like while saving, while kind of like cheating. I don't know if it's cheating, it's just a different way of doing it. We're not doing one continuous run. If this run goes well, then I'll do a continuous run. All right, we gotta play this really carefully. Ooh. Oh, okay. Okay, that actually worked. We didn't collect any coins. We beat Rango. I really hope I don't spawn in a coin. I think I might spawn in a coin. Oh, I didn't. That was a close one. Okay, we're doing good. We're gonna have to make it through the Woody Kingdom without collecting any coins, which I don't really know how to do, but it can't be too hard. Okay, we just collected a coin that wasn't even my fault, dude. You guys see that? There's a coin in this bush. How was I supposed to know that? That really sucks. Good thing I saved right before this. Oh my God, that would have sucked if I didn't save. Guys, so we're on version 1.2, but we have like an infinite amount of time. I know there are no coins if we go up this way. So we're gonna sit here and just do rock clip for like a million years until we get it. It is possible in version 1.2, but it's like, it takes way, way longer. It's a lot more precise. All right, you know what? We're just gonna find a different way to do this. Sixth shortcut that we're gonna take advantage of that I never really get to use anywhere else. Boom, right there. So now we're gonna do that. Okay. Okay, there we go. Fierce and Fire, tell me about the benefits of Twitch Prime. Well, pretty much, with Twitch Prime, you get the satisfaction of knowing that you wasted your money on a stupid ginger boy. Which you can't get in many other places, you know? Most gingers on YouTube, if you give money to them, that money will go to good use. But with me, dude, you know that you wasted your money. I'm like 90% sure, if I recall correctly, there's like coins right here. Alright, here's how we're gonna find out. How do we know? Oh, there aren't, because we can do a ground pound. Oh, there are no coins there. Alright, we're good, never mind. Because when we do a ground pound, it kind of shows you where the coins are. Oh my gosh, there's coins right there. Alright, boys, we gotta be careful. IRL streams, it's the way of the future. Because I was like, man, dude, if I just streamed my life, my IRL life, so many people would relate. It's literally just me procrastinating, watching Netflix and YouTube on my bed, hoping that nobody's gonna yell at me, knowing that my mom's gonna come in any 5 minutes and say something horrible about how I'm a loser. I feel like a lot of humans would be able to relate to that. Or just vlogs in general. If I did vlogs and I just vlogged myself being a freaking loser, unproductive idiot, think about the amount of humans that could relate to that. The entire, like, my entire audience could relate to that. Like, it would be like a level of realness you don't see anywhere else. Can I make food videos where, like, I don't actually make the food, but somebody else makes the food for me, and I just eat the food? While playing video games? Is that allowed? Am I allowed to do that? And I don't like want to like review the food either. I just want to eat it and play games. Is that allowed? Can I do that? It's called mukbang? Mukbang. I should be a mukbanger. A speedrunner who switched into mukbang. Ooh, I like the sound of that, dude. If your son wants to bang mucks, that's not what I said. I don't even think mucks are a real thing, unless your name is Muck. God damn it. Okay. Dude, there's like that one dude out there whose name is Muck, and he's just like disgusted right now. He's like, oh god, not again. He's like, this happens every time. What's up, Chaos? What the hell, dude? That's so stupid. That was dumb. I didn't even touch the freaking block. Guys, I should honestly be a YouTube sleeper. Somebody that just like sleeps. If I was a girl, dude, people would watch that. It's called porn? How is that porn? How is watching somebody sleep porn? It's porn if it turns somebody on? So am I, because I know that there's people that freaking say that I turn them on. Does that mean that I do pornography? Am I like a pornographer? Or porn star? Is Fearsome Fire secretly a porn star? I just got a coin. Well, that sucks. I am sick of my freaking fan base being so immature, alright? Like, I'm fine, alright. Like, I understand you guys are 12. I'm fine if you're 12 years old, but I kind of wish you would act like you're older, you know? That's all I'm asking. You guys act like you're freaking four-year-olds. Dude, I don't want to be known for being the guy that says controversial shit. Like, I realize that's what I'm known for already, but that's not, like, what I'm going for, right? You guys are so stupid. I hate life. That sucks. This is gonna take years. I'm fine if you're 12 years old, Fearsome Fire 2018. I hate you so much. I said that, didn't I? Like, I understand you guys are 12. I'm fine if you're 12 years old. I'm fine if you're 12 years old. I'm fine if you're 12 years old. God damn it. I see the entire chat talking about. Rachel, how's it going? Talking about what? Oh, about what I'm talking about. Guys, I met Rachel in New York. Rachel was probably the most mature, like, person out of the group we were with. You weren't that mature, but you were more mature than, like, everybody else there. I appreciate that, alright? There was this couple, guys. We were, like, walking in the park, and there were these people having sex. And everybody else I was with was trying to, like, go get closer to them, and I was, like, really scared, dude. For some reason, it just, like, I wanted to run the other way. Like, I saw sex, I wanted to run away. Like, that scared me. But everybody else, like, was, like, trying to get closer, and yeah, it was a yikes, dude. Did I record it? No. I think Plain Rock recorded it. I don't know if Plain Rock's gonna upload it. I know he recorded part of it. But yeah, Plain Rock recorded part of it, I think. Right, didn't he? I think he did. God damn it, dude. This is impossible. This sucks. Why? How did I touch that? Why? Oh my god, this is impossible. Oh, yes. No! Oh my gosh. So, we're pretty sure there are coins on top of here. So, there's two ways we can go about this. It is possible to do a Cappy roll jump and make it from down here to the other platform, but it's really hard. Or, we could try to go that way, like the regular path. Should we go the regular path, or should we do the really hard Cappy roll jump? Dude, you're right, we can't touch the poster either. We gotta be really careful, okay. So here's how we're gonna do this. We're gonna come here. Dude, we did it. Okay, okay, boys. We are popping off a little bit. All right. Okay, Mecha Wiggler looks pretty simple. I'm not going to SawCon. SawCon these nuts. How did I get a coin? I got a coin. When did I get a coin? What? When did I get a coin? How did that happen? When did that happen? When the other tank explodes. So apparently there was another tank there that exploded. And it automatically gave me a coin. Capture slash uncapture him so he despawns? Are you serious? What? Alright, so we just gotta capture this dude. Come this way. Wet pigeons, thank you. Aha, now! Did he appear? He freaking despawned at the perfect opportunity. So we didn't collect a coin that time. We're popping off! Oh my god, okay, that was really easy. Alright. No tank. No tank. No tank. There's no coin. Where did we get a coin? I hate you so much, dude. The chat was saying that I got a coin. They were like trolling me. We did it. We got no coins. I don't know what. I don't know how we got a coin the other time. I must have accidentally done something else. Does this give coins? Can we ground pound this without getting a coin? I guess not. Guys, when I went to New York and I was going back home at like the freaking train station because I took the train because I'm a freaking legend because trains are amazing. There was a Krispy Kreme and I ate Krispy Kreme and it was the first time eating Krispy Kreme in 5 years and it was so good and I want more Krispy Kreme. I like snuck Krispy Kreme in on the train and everybody was looking at me like I was stupid. There's not enough Krispy Kreme to go around. I don't know why they thought that it'd be a good idea to put, like, no Krispy Kremes in Massachusetts. There's not a single Krispy Kreme in Massachusetts. I remember when I was a little kid, they had Krispy Kreme in Massachusetts. And they got rid of them all because people in Massachusetts are stupid. I remember going to Krispy Kreme with my dad before my parents got divorced. And that was, like, one of my most fondest memories in my life was going to Krispy Kreme. My dad took me there before my parents were divorced, before everything fell apart. And it was magnificent. And, like, right when my parents got divorced, all the Krispy Kremes in Massachusetts went out of business. It's almost like it was a sign. It's almost like they were telling me something. They literally decided to get rid of every Krispy Kreme right when my parents got divorced. So it was like there was double unhappiness at once, you know? There was like so many different reasons for me to be sad and unhappy about life. But then when I ate Krispy Kreme the other day, it reminded me of those good memories that I had that I wish I still could experience, but I can't. My girlfriend actually broke up with me because I wouldn't stop blabbing on about canes. That's a lie. I don't have a girlfriend. But if I did, she'd probably break up with me. That's the only reason she'd break up with me, though. There's no other reason why my girlfriend would break up with me. It's just because I'd go on about canes. I can't think of any other reason why a girl wouldn't want to be with me. She might feel threatened that you have better eyebrows than her. That's what I'm saying, dude! Girls are just scared of me because they know that my eyebrows are just so good and they'll never be able to compete with my beautiful eyebrows. See, guys, that's the real reason I'm single. That's the real reason. It's not because people don't want to be with me, it's because they feel threatened because I'm just that amazing. Think of your school, the most attractive and popular guy. He probably doesn't get any woman because they're all just jealous. That's actually not true at all. All of, like, the really attractive guys at my school all had girlfriends. And it always kind of pissed me off. See, that also sounded really gay now that I'm thinking about it. The reason it pissed me off wasn't because I was jealous of them. It was because I was jealous of the fact that they had girlfriends and I didn't. It wasn't because I wanted to be with them. God damn it. Yeah, it's over for me. Okay. I was doing you a favor by not streaming at good times. I just jumped right into a coin. No. What did I do? What did I do? Wait, guys, what did I do? Did I mess it up? I didn't save properly. I deleted my other save. Okay, then. I guess we're restarting. I literally saw the... Whatever. Honestly, I mean, the fact that I messed up the save, I would have just ended up messing up anyways. I feel like if I had a real-life Cappy and it worked, the first thing I would do, I would capture a girl. No, I wouldn't do anything, like, you know, messed up. I would just want to experience what it's like to deal with the hardships of being a female. And just to relate to her on an emotional level. Obviously. That's the only reason I would want to become a female. You know? Only reason, guys. Only reason. You know? Because females in this world go through way more hardship than males. And I would just want to be able to sympathize with women on a psychological level. Yeah, of course I would get her consent. I wouldn't do it without consent. I wouldn't capture... I mean, well, alright. No, of course, yeah. Of course I would ask for consent. Although Mario doesn't really ask for consent. So do you really need consent? I feel like if Mario doesn't ask for consent, it doesn't really matter. Because Mario doesn't ask for consent. But he's not, like, doing anything wrong with people's bodies. Like, I wouldn't, like, do something horrible. I would just capture their body temporarily, go out, and see what it's like to be a woman. What are the consent laws for Cappy capturing, though? That's what I'm saying, dude. There's no laws for Cappy captures. If you actually captured somebody with Cappy, is that even really their body anymore? Don't you kind of own them? You know? I feel like I would kind of own that woman if, like, I used Cappy to capture her. I almost just freaking got a coin. I'm saying it'd be different because you're capturing their body with Cappy. Like, think about it. When Mario captures a Bullet Bill, the Bullet Bill isn't even aware that it's a Bullet Bill anymore. You know, like, if... like, I feel like because... Oh my god, this is horrible. Because the Bullet Bill doesn't know what's happening... I need to slow down a little bit here. I can't think of anything to say to, like, save myself. Guys. You know what? I would never capture somebody without their consent. Just gonna leave it at that.
So after this point in the speedrun, I pretty much just went through the rest of the kingdoms just like I did in the previous attempt, up until the Luncheon Kingdom, where I realized that I made a fatal saving error once again.
Oh, I collected a coin? Did I? Wait a minute, I just realized something. Did I screw this up? Did I mess up the whole save file thing? I don't have the energy for this anymore. Please tell me I didn't. No. No. Oh my god, dude. Oh, that one hurts. That one really hurts. That really hurts. I'm not gonna lie. That's painful. That's really painful.